little shark because it is the inflatable sea lion here. And today I'm doing a video on how to keep betta fish with other fish peacefully, safely, and happily. So first I'm going to talk about the basic guidelines of picking out the fish and setting up your tank. And then I'm going to talk about the fish that can be kept with males, and then I'm going to talk about the fish that can be kept with females, because females have a wider variety of fish that you can keep with them. So that's why I have a female. I'm going to talk about some species that aren't fish that you can keep with your bettas, and I'm going to talk about some huge no-nos that a lot of people do and say you can do, but you definitely cannot, and I'm going to explain why. So talking about the basic guidelines, you need to avoid all biting fish, or what fish enthusiasts call nibblers. If they tend to get agitated easily and nibble fins, I would stay away from colorful fish, which of course this can be avoided. As you can see, my bright orange fancy guppy just swam right past my betta fish. I would say no larger fish than the betta, because they might feel intimidated and tormented, so avoid that. And the larger fish actually might harm the betta fish, even though you'd think the betta fish would harm the other fish, but stay away from larger fish. They must be compatible, in needs, and I'm going to talk about this with the no-no fish that a lot of people try, and I'm going to say one example here is keeping goldfish with betta fish. And I see it all the time, but it's like the worst combination you could possibly have. I'll talk about that near the end of the video. You must have at least a 15-gallon to attempt this, because the betta needs its space, because they are quite territorial, and if a fish is in its space, it is going to feel obligated to bite or chase it away, pretty much, which you will see if your tank is not large enough, or if you just introduce the betta, or even if the betta just sort of acclimated to their surroundings. So just be aware of that. And finally, your tank must be heavily planted. You can't see here, this is just the top, like, 1/4 section of my tank. But the bottom, which I will just quick show you, is very heavily planted, and there are tons of nooks and crannies to hide, especially behind here, behind those plants. I see my fish go inside the plants, so you need to have tons of plants, whether that be plastic plants or live plants. But I really do prefer plastic plants because there's less algal blooms, but that's totally up to you. Live plants do produce more oxygen and it can be more beneficial for the fish, so just be aware of that. Now I'm going to talk about fish that can be kept with male betta fish, and a lot of people want to have the male betta fish because they have a much more fancier and elegant fins, so I'm talking about both instead of just females. Now my female actually looks like a male because her fins are huge, but she does have an egg spot and she doesn't have the what I call a puffed man beard when she flares. Like, if you hold up a mirror, this is how to tell the gender. If they will have a puff under them that looks like a man beard, then it is a male. But if they don't, it is a female. And as well, you can look at the bottom of the betta fish and they will have a white spot, which is called the egg spot. So my betta fish doesn't have the man beard and it does have an egg spot, so it's a female, even though people never believe me when I tell them that. So the fish that can be kept with male betta fish, I would say, are neon tetras, cardinal tetras, bristlenose plecos, glass catfish, quarry catfish, coolie loach, feeder guppies, and minnows, even though they're not the prettiest fish to look at, but they're definitely compatible and completely safe. One of the best to keep with a male betta. So as well, you can have rasboras. Now, female betta fish have a lot more fish you can keep them with. You can keep them with any of the fish that were mentioned in the males. So the neon tetra, cardinal tetra, bristlenose, pleco, glass catfish, koi catfish, coolie loach, feeder guppies, minnows, rasboras. But they can also be kept with other female betta fish, which a lot of people didn't know that, but you can have female sorority tanks of bettas, but you must have at least three, and four is quite more recommended, because if you have two, they will fight over the territory, but when there is more, then they're totally safe together. And you can actually have combinations of all the fish. I would just look up if they're compatible in the first place. So like if you have a male, you can keep neon tetras with cardinal tetras and minnows. I don't know, but just look up how to care for all of those before you set up a tank. Females can also be kept with guppies, mollies, platies, and swordtails. And I do keep mine, and that includes fancy guppies actually. But you need to have a much larger tank for fancy guppies. I advise only doing that with a 20-gallon tank if you want fancy guppies and mollies, platies, and swordtails. So that's like, a lot of people say that's a huge no-no, but it definitely can be done, obviously, because I'm doing it right now. So there you go. As well, I'd like to add endlers to that list, which are a newer species of fish. I have them in there, so they're totally safe. I would just like to add that my molly, my betta fish doesn't really like my balloon molly actually that I have because she's sort of clumsy and when it comes to eating she like shoves everybody out of the way. So the betta fish doesn't really like her, but there is no chasing or fin nipping, which really surprised me there. So anyways, the not fish that can be kept with betta fish, and this is males and females, are the African dwarf frog, which are very peaceful and can be kept with almost any tropical fish. Ghost shrimp, which I wouldn't advise keeping with betta fish because they tend not to live very long. They're usually only sold to be like feeders, and the people at like big chain pet stores aren't really trained enough, I'd like to say, and aren't aware of that. So just, I wouldn't really advise ghost shrimp, but you can do it if you want. Red cherry shrimp, which are highly advised, and any type of snail, mystery snails, apple snails, nearite snails, you know, just any type of tropical snail. And huge no-nos. Now this one I see all the time. I talked this about this one earlier in the beginning, and that is goldfish. No goldfish. You cannot keep goldfish together because, yes, you can keep goldfish together. You can't keep goldfish with bettas because they just have completely opposite requirements in tank areas, you know? Like, okay, so goldfish are cold water fish. They like to be in the 60s range, but betta fish like low 80s and high 70s, so you definitely can't have a temperature that they will both like, and there's no, oh, I'll just make it 75 in the middle. No, that will just agitate both of them. Do not put them together. And I see it all the time, and people are like, they don't fight. Why is my goldfish dying? Why is my betta fish dying? Because you just can't reach both of their needs. As well, I think they require a different pH. I'm not sure about that though, but temperature is probably one of the largest things that affect it, so definitely don't have them together. Now, another no-no is cichlids. I don't care what kind of cichlid you have, you just can't keep them together because they are considered fin nippers, and some can get a lot larger than betta fish, and some can be colorful, and betta fish don't like large, colorful fish. They find that as a territory threat, and they just, no, don't like it. And they're also, it just doesn't work, I'm just gonna say. So, and one that some people do for some reason are tiger barbs. That is a huge no-no, because tiger barbs are major fin nippers. They are very aggressive fish, and if someone's in their area, they're gonna bite, they're gonna rip fins, and they don't care. So, no tiger barbs. In fact, I wouldn't advise any other barbs, no barbs at all. So, There we go. No gouramis because they are closely related to betta fish. And you might think, oh, that's a good thing. So a lot of people keep them with gouramis. I'd say blue gouramis might be okay. Might be okay. But why get blue gouramis? I seriously love them. I'm just saying, I had one like 5 years ago and it lived for like probably 6 years. And I'm not sure if that was even how long they're supposed to live, but it lived for 6 years. And he seemed very peaceful, but a lot of people just know other gouramis other than that blue gourami, but I wouldn't really advise that because not a lot of people keep them together, so you don't really have any proof that it's safe. But if you're one of the people that like to go out there and test things, then go ahead, put your betta with the blue gourami. I don't know, I would only try it with a female because females can handle a lot more than a male can. Just saying. Anyways, like I was saying, people think, oh, they're very closely related, it's perfect. But no, bettas don't like each other. So it's like being kept with your in-laws. You probably don't like them, you know? So fish aren't gonna like their in-laws. So just don't keep them together. Now, another huge no-no, a lot of inexperienced people get betta fish as their first fish, and really, it's not that good of a first fish. Nobody knows what a good first fish is because all fish have a huge requirements like pH and temperature and all that, and people can't reach that. They don't understand what ammonia is, nitrates, they don't know what any of that is, and they try to throw a goldfish in a bowl, but that's horrible and you're not meeting their conditions. You know, the only good thing about a goldfish is they don't need a heater, so maybe that'd be a good starter. But anyways, beginners just, they're like, I want betta fish. So they grab like 3 male betta fish usually. They'll just get males or maybe 2 males and a female, and they throw them together in a tank. And there's fin ripping and there's chasing and there's killing. Do not put betta fish together. And they usually do that in like a 5-gallon tank. Put 3 bettas together, all males. It's like, what are you doing? And pet shop owners don't even tell them usually. And they just sell them the 3 bettas. If somebody bought like 3 male bettas or like 2 males and a female, I'd be like, hey, what are you doing with those betta fish? Are you like, how are you going to tank them? Do you have 3 separate tanks? Yeah, so I would educate somebody, especially if it was a little kid, but I've seen it before. I've seen children buy like 2 or 3 betta fish and they put them all together. And it's like, what are you doing? Well, I don't know that, but I'm guessing they put them all together. I see people on YouTube that have betta fish together, and sometimes it works if they're raised as a fry their whole life to keep like a few together, but yeah, they're still gonna be fin nipping and chasing, especially if you have a male with a female. That is just totally not a good combination. So don't do that. I actually did that when I was about 6 years old. My brother and I got a fish, and he got a male and I got a female, and nobody told us anything. We were just like, I was a 6 year old and he was a 4 year old, and we just went up to the counter and purchased a male and female betta fish and one tank at the same time. And nobody told us anything. And the guy helped us pick them out. So it's a lot of ignorant things that people aren't teaching you when you buy the fish. So just be extremely aware of that. Do tons of research so you can make sure your betta fish or any fish is in the best needs. So that pretty much closes up how to keep betta fish with other fish and what other fish you can keep them with. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful. Follow me on Instagram. I do have a fish Instagram called Glorious Guppies. The username may change, so just be aware of that. I'd maybe click on my latest video and look in the description. But I want you to tag me with pictures of your betta fish living with other fish. And I think that'd be pretty interesting to see. And just follow me. I follow everyone back. So there you go. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, if it helped you, make sure you like it. If you're not part of the shark pool already, make sure to join us by clicking subscribe, and see you little sharks.